welcome. This service is provided by freeconferencecall.com. The recording has started.
Can you see the screen?
Yes.
क्रतुण्ड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ धातुब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्सुबन्तादिर् धातु ब्रह्मात्मने नमः। ओके, सो वी वर लुकिंग एट दी अर्थाज ऑफ सुबंता सुबंता दी विभक्ति विभक्ति अर्थ। वी ऑल्सो सॉ दी उपसर्गज हाउ दे कैन चेंज द मीनिंग फॉर ऑफ एनी धातु। दे कैन कीप इट सेम, दे कैन चेंज इट, और दे कैन गिव एन ऑपोजिट मीनिंग। लॉट ऑफ पॉसिबिलिटीज आर देयर। Subanta, so first case we saw the meaning, that first case in Kartari Prayoga is Karta, Karakartha, Karta, and Karma in Karmani Prayoga. Then subjective complement is also possible, like saying that Ramaha Viraha Asti. So Rama is brave, there brave is a subjective complement, it is not an object. In English we saw that sometimes people misunderstand the predicate to be an object. But in Sanskrit, it is not like that. So that's Kartari Prayoga, Karta in first case, and Karma in first case in Karmani Prayoga. That is Karakartha. Then non-Karaka Vibhakti. Non-Karaka Vibhakti is Sambodhana, when you address a person directly. That is the first case. Second case, Karma or objective complement. Karma in Kartari Prayoga or Dvitiya Karma in Dvikarmaka Dhatu in Karmani Prayoga. But generally meaning is Karma in Kartari Prayoga, the object of the verb goes in second case in Kartari Prayoga. That is Karaka Vibhakti. Non-Karaka Vibhakti, there are various words which govern, there are various avyayas which govern second case. By saying govern second case means whenever you use these avyayas like Prati, Anu, Antarena, these kind of words, then it's like an object to that. It is not something like an object, that's why it goes in second case. There are other possibilities also, like not only necessarily second case, there may be other cases also for a same avyaya. There are multiple cases possible. One of them is second case, that is the meaning here. So prati, you get moksham prati iccha asti. Sometimes we say, see seventh case also, but here pratigaman, second case. So moksham prati iccha bhavati, asti or bhavati. Main sentence kartari prayoga is bhavati. You start by analyzing bhavati, latlakara vartamana kala, there is asti or bhavati. What is iccha bhavati? Desire is there. Desire towards what? When the akamsha is towards what, then we say prati, towards. Towards that, when you supply towards what, that what is a akamsha, is a karma akamsha, you get, so you decline the word in moksha, akaranta pullinga shabda, in second case you say moksham prati iccha bhavati. Similarly, upadesham anu saha vedan bodhati. Bodhati is, you remove ti, you get the bodha, bodha as the anga. The gana vikarna pratya a, you can see sitting there, you remove that, you get bodh, bodh, halanta, halanta as in consonant ending. Bodh. In bodh, you can see the ukara has become okara. You can guess that. And reverse engineer the dhatu to be budh. And budh is in the sense of budh jnane. So, in the sense of knowledge. So, bodhati, vedan bodhati, one understands. Understands who saha. Saha is someone, anyone. Anyone, one person, a person understands Vedas. How does he understand Vedas? Anu. So Vedani second case, because bodhati sah bodhati, one understands. What does he understand? Vedas. So he understands Vedas. But now the Akamsha is, how does he understand Vedas? Anu. Anu means in keeping with. In keeping with or following. Following the traditional teaching, following the teaching. So Anu is in keeping with. Then with what? That what Akamsha? In keeping with is the meaning of Anu. Then in keeping with, when the Akamsha is there, you'll ask what? In keeping with what? That will also go in second case. Upadesham Anu. But this Upadesham is second case, Vedan is also second case. We should not make this Upadesham with Bodhati. Upadesham Bodhati na, it is not Upadesham Bodhati. That is also, there is no error, erroneous statement it will not be. But here Anu is there, therefore, otherwise the sentence you can say Vedan Anu Upadesham Bodhati will also be possible to make an Anvaya. There it will mean that one understands the teaching in keeping with the Vedas. But that is not the intention here. You understand because teacher follows the Vedas. Vedas do not follow the teacher. That's why the sentence construct we have to analyze how it fits well. Because I mentioned earlier, you must be knowing that the word, the order of words is not important in writing or in saying something in Sanskrit. The Anvaya, when you make the understanding, that time you can reorganize the words if you want. Antarena. Antarena also governs second case. Putram antarena devadatta na tushyati. Tushyati is, one is not happy. Devadatta is not happy. Why is, when he is not happy, antarena. Antarena is without. Without his son. If the son is away, the father is not happy. That is the meaning. So putram antarena governs second case. That is the idea here. Antarena without. Without what? That what will be in second case. Tritiya vibhakti. Tritiya vibhakti. So what is the second case? Second case karma in kartari prayoga. Takes second case, and prati, anu, antarena, these govern second case. In fact, if you translate the word right, you know English, you land on the second case anyway. In most cases, of course. Tritiya vibhakti, karaka vibhakti is karanam, we have seen, hastena khadati, an instrument to get the desired result out of the action in the verb, in the word. That dhatu artha, whatever is the dhatu intending to achieve, that person through that action, whatever he is trying to achieve, that will be karma. But the means through which, the sadhana, the tool through which he is trying to attain that action is the karana. That is the karakartha. Like devadatta hastena odanam khadati. Khadati is khadhatu, khadati. You add a and then ti, tip. Khadati eats. What does he eat? That will go in second case. One, devadatta eats. Because kartari prayoga, khadati kartari prayoga, you should look for the first case. So main sentence will be devadatta khadati. That is the sentence, main sentence. Devadatta eats. Now what does he eat? Odanam. He eats rice. Then through what does he eat? So he eats by hand, with hand. With his hands he eats rice. So hastena or chamasena, with a spoon. Modern day devadatta will eat through a spoon. So odana hastena khadyate. This is karmani prayoga. In karmani prayoga, the... You see, hastena, by hand, using his hand, that remains common whether it is kartari prayoga or karmani prayoga. In both cases, the karana will go in third case only. But additionally, odanaha hastena khadyate. Khadyate is karmani prayoga, not khadati, khadyate. You can see khad dhatu, khad da, khad plus a plus t will be khadati. But khad, without adding a vikarana pratyaya a, you just add ya, you get khadya, and then te, atmane pada pratyaya, instead of ti, you add te. You get khadyate, third person singular. Khadyate is eaten. What is eaten? Then the akanksha will be what is eaten, not who eats, but what is eaten. Therefore, karma will go in first case, odanaha. Instead of odanam in second case, you get odanaha in first case in karmani prayoga, because karma is denoted by the verb. Odanaha khadyate is your main sentence. Then, kena khadyate, kena is by what, through what does he eat, using what as a means, hastena, using his hand. Now, using, rice is eaten by hand, when you make that kind of statement, then you is eaten by hand, by whom? By everyone, by also, but devadatta. So you want to say by devadatta, that by devadatta is a tritiya. So karta goes in third case in karmani prayoga. So the sentence, if you want to supply a karta, Akanksha is kena khadyate, by whom is it eaten? By devadatta. So you say devadattena. रामेण लाइक दैट रामा डिक्लिनेशन अकारांत पुल्लिंग देवदत्त शब्द देवदत्तेन ओदन हस्तेन खाद्यते योर राइस इज ईटन बाय देवदत्त यूजिंग हिज हैंड्स दिस इज दी करण अर्थ देन कर्ता अर्थ ऑल्सो आई मेंशन सो ओदन देवदत्तेन हस्तेन खाद्यते दैट इज देवदत्तेन इज ऑल्सो थर्ड केस Hasten is also third case, but you have to differentiate. Now, instrumental, if you use the instrumental case as the translation for Tritiya, this sentence, Devadatta will also become an instrument, but that is not how the understanding should be. It is a Tritiya Vibhakti. You have to question in what meaning is the Tritiya Vibhakti. So, Hastena is an instrumental case, but Devadattena is a Kartari, is a Karta. So, you should not get confused between Kartari Tritiya and Kartari Prayoga. Kartari Prayoga, this is not. This sentence is Karmani Prayoga. But Devadatta, Devadattena, that third case will be called as Kartari Tritiya. Kartari Tritiya in the sense, this third case, Tritiya, is in the sense of Karta. This seventh case, the meaning of seventh case here is Vishaya Saptami. What is called as Saptami? Saptami Vibhakti, seventh case. But Kartari, Kartru Pratipadika is there. In seventh case, it will decline as Kartari is the 7-1 as in singular saptami prathama saptami ekavachana the singular of seventh case kartari meaning in the sense of a karta in the meaning of the karta is this tritiya so kartari tritiya will mean not the prayoga but the case what is the meaning of the case that is devadattena but here it will be Karne Tritiya. Hastena will be Karne Tritiya. Devadattene is Kartari Tritiya. But the entire sentence, Odanaha Devadattena Hastena Khadhyate, that is Karmani Prayoga. Prayoga and the case we have to differentiate. So that is the Karaka Vibhakti. Non-Karaka Vibhakti Tritiya, what is the meaning for Tritiya? Hetu. Hetu is very important. You will see Hetu. In third case, so let's say sipunyena, the sentence construct is labhate, now labhate is kartari prayoga or karmani, how do I know? Now you do not see a ya here, ya is nowhere there in the picture, when ya is there then you have to analyze whether it is fourth, can it be fourth case? First of all it is atmane, we know that it is not ti, it is te, therefore it is atmane declension and atmane of which dhatu now? I don't see here, so labha, if it is there, dhatu, then labhate, here, if it is karmani prayoga, then ya would have been sitting. Now, ya, since ya is not there, which is yak, yak we say, yak is the pratyaya, the content is ya. When ya is not there, then it is kartari prayoga. If it is kartari prayoga, then gana vikarna pratyaya will definitely be there, and gana vikarna pratyaya from what we know, this is a. So you remove a, you will get love. Love is the dhatu. Love is in the sense of to attain. Prapane. Prapane artha to attain. Then love means one attains. This is how you will translate. Kartari prayoga. Not it is attained, but one attains. So one attains. Who is that? So who attains? Now this is not labhate. Here what is one attains? What does one attain? Because here the karta is not supplied. You can say that I do not want to supply karta because you are not saying devadatta or someone. Anyone attains. So manushyatvam labhate. Therefore manushyatvam is karma. It is not first case. Here manushyatvam is the tva. Tva that you see here. Manushya is the word that we all know. Then tva and in neuter tvam it will become tvam. Manushyatvam, that tvam is the status. It is a quality. It is a jati. It is a species, category is indicated. Manushyatva means that quality which makes a person a manushya. Similarly, ghatatvam, if I say ghatatvam is that quality, that attribute, that jati, which is pervades all ghatas, which is there in all ghatas, that commonality, that general thing, that which helps me identify that it is a ghata, is called its jati, and that will be indicated by tvam. You will see manushyatvam in neuter, or you will have manushyata, ta will be there in the end, that is ta is feminine, manushyata, and manushyata in second case will be manushyatam, manushyatam labhate or manushyatvam labhate. One attends human birth, manushyatvam human birth or translation will be humanity, but it is here the meaning is human birth. Manushyattvam labhate means what? Human birth is attained. One attains human birth. So anyone, sarvaha. Sarvaha you can supply in first case saying that sarvaha or lokaha. Lokaha manushyattvam labhate. Loka, actually loka will already mean manushya. So therefore it is not supplied. Sarvaha or we can say jivaha. Jivaha manushyattvam labhate. Jiva can be in animal body also, plant body also, and in human body also. Therefore, the jiva attains the human birth, manushyattvam. Kena, now kena hetuna. Kena hetuna means by, due to what reason? How is that a person, the jiva, that individual becomes a human, is born in a human body or in an animal body, in a plant body? There has to be some particular cause for human birth, and that cause we say punyena. Actually, punyena is not technically correct, because punya and papa, both admixture should be there. There should be almost 50-50 of punya and papa to get a human birth. If it is only punya, then a person will attain deva sharira. And only papa is there, one will attain kita or the animal body or in hellish planets, we say. But punya and papa mixture is there, but punya overrides the papa a little. So we will say 51-49 kind of a ratio. There the person will get a human birth. And therefore we see a lot of varieties in humans based on how much is the punya, how much is the papa. Punyena manushyatvam. This punyena is what now? This punyena is non-karaka tritiya, which is hetuvarthe. Hetuvarthe we will say. Hetuvarthe in the meaning of hetu. So hetu tritiya. We will call it hetu tritiya. Hetu is seventh case of hetu shabda, ukaranta. And hetu, when you decline in seventh case, here it is Vishaya Saptami, in the sense of, in the meaning of Hetu, reason. So Punya is the Hetu, therefore it is in third case. Punyena Manushyattva Jivaha Labhate. A Jiva attains Manushyattva Punyena, due to Punya, because of Punya, due to Punya, on account of Punya. These are the translations we use. Then there is, I'll just mention it. I'll not talk about this Ittambhute. Ittambhute is very difficult to understand, but people use it variously. I'll just mention, give an example. I will not see these examples. These examples are themselves are questionable. let's say a person. So we say Jatabhi Sadhu. Jatabhi is third case plural of Jata Shabda. Jata means the long hair which are what is a braided hair. So Jatabhi, or let's say Kamandulna Sadhu. So Kamandulu, one Kamandulna Sadhu or Brahmachari. Earlier days Brahmacharis who would go for a class, anywhere they would go for Achamana, they would carry water, because Brahmachari has to keep himself Shuddha by doing Achamana and do Sandhya regularly. All this was there. He would carry water, and to carry a water he needs a patra. For Bhiksha also he would use a patra. So Kamandulu is an indicator to that allows you to find out that the person is a brahmachari or a sadhu. So using what? That tritiya, which is that characterizes the person, that brings the character of the person out for you, it indicates something. That kind of tritiya is called ittam bhute tritiya. Ittam is in this manner. You know it in this manner, that since he carries the kamandalu, then he is a person, upalakshita we say, kamandaluna upalakshita sadhu or brahmachari or balaka, chhatra, a student is known via the kamandalu that he carries. That is the tritiya, kamandaluna, kamandalu, that will be ittham bhute tritiya. So you have to know, first you have to know that a person who carries a kamandalu is a brahmachari. First you, that understanding should be there. Then only next time you see a person carrying a kamandalu, then you know that, oh, this has to be a brahmachari, because he is carrying a, that is not a hetu. Just because anyone carries a kamandalu does not become a brahmachari. But brahmachari, the way in which he is carrying, that will indicate the brahmachari. Thereby, it is ittambhute tritiya. Anyway, ittambhute tritiya, even if we don't understand now, it's okay. Then there is saha tritiya. Saha tritiya is, saha means along. You don't translate saha as along with. When you say saha, this saha governs third case. Saha, along. Along, then when you say along with whom or with what, that with will be the third case in what is called as saha tritiya. So Ramaha Gachati, Ramaha goes to forest. So if you say where does he go to the forest, that Gam Dhatu will take karma in second case, the destination goes in second case. Ramaha, let's say Gachati. So he asks Putra Gachati, where does he go? He goes to forest. So Vanam Gachati. Ramaha Vanam Gachati. But Lakshmana says, I will also come. Therefore, Lakshmanena Saha Ramaha Vanam Gachati. Ramaha goes to forest along what? Saha along. Along with whom? That with whom is Lakshmanena. Lakshmanena is with Lakshmana. Lakshmanena Saha Ramaha Gachati. Now Saha is is giving away the Tritiya is Saha Tritiya. But there may be a Saha missing also. There can be Lakshmanena Ramaha Gachati will also be a right sentence. Saha is helping us understand it as Saha Tritiya. But Lakshmanena on its own can also be used. Lakshmanena Ramaha Gachati will be Lakshmanena Saha only. It can not be interpreted any other way. Because Lakshmana will not be a tool. Rama does not go to forest using the instrumental. See, that is the flaw of instrumental case. Lakshmanena, if you say instrumental case, you will say that Lakshmana is an instrument for Rama to go. It's actually a nonsensical construct. Therefore, we should prefer to stick to Sanskrit Arthas. We should say Tritiya. That is, the third case is also fine. But to say instrumental is an instrumental case is ridiculous. That is Tritiya. There is also the adverb. Adverb also goes in Tritiya in all genders. Now, I didn't cover that in the second case because she's also missed it. Second case, neuter singular. Only neuter singular can be used in adverbial sense. Not dual, not plural, and not any other gender except for neuter. So neuter second case singular can be adverbial. Like for example, one runs. So I'll just mention a sentence. Let's say you make a sentence that Devadattaha. I don't have Varaha open. Okay, I'll just mention the sentence right now. Devadattaha Dhavati. Dhavati is runs. So when you say Devadatta runs, how does he run? What is basically an adverb? Adverb qualifies the verb. It is like an adjective to the verb. So Visheshana. Visheshana to the verb. And that is called as Kriya Visheshana. It is a Visheshana adjective to the verb Kriya. Therefore, it is Kriya Visheshana and that is adverb. So, Kriya Visheshana Kriya Visheshana, you will have, let's say sentence is Devadattaha Dhavati runs. Now, the manner in which one runs will go either in second case or second case neuter singular or third case any gender and any of the number. So Devadatta Dhavati, the word for runs, how does he run? He runs fast. So you say Vega is the Shabda, Vega. So Vega is the Shabda. Now Vega, neuter will be Vegam, Vegam Dhavati. Vegam Dhavati means he runs speedily will translate, or Vegena Dhavati. Vegena, with speed. So with speed is disclosing the manner in which one runs, and therefore it is qualifying the verb. So you will have the meaning Devadatta runs speedily. We translate as speedily. We add ili to make it an adverb. So this is another meaning possible in third case as well as in second case. Chaturthi Vibhakti. Fourth case we have seen Sampradanam. When you give something, the action, the Karaka Artha is, Sampradanam is the entity to which something is given without an expectation of return. So Devadattaha Dadati. Dadati means Dadhatu Dadane, to give. Dadati, he gives something. And here Dadati, you see Dadane, Da has become Dada. And Dada, so you know here there is reduplication. And reduplication is a characteristic of a third gana. Third gana, Dadati. This Dane arthe in the meaning of giving, but in the third gana, therefore it has, the dhatu has duplicated. Dada, it has become, and then the akara drops off, you get Dada. Dada plus ti is Dadati. Dhanam. And the akara shab comes and goes, therefore you have the anga will not have additional akara, but akara, if it could have caused guna, it would have caused. Here there is nothing to cause guna. Dadati, gives. Who gives? Devadatta gives. Devadatta, what does he give? Dhanam, second case. What Akanksha is there? Therefore, Dhana will take second case. Dhanam dadati, he gives money. To whom does he give money without an expectation of return? That is Sampradana. This is Chaturthi. Sampradane Chaturthi. Sampradane Arthe, in the meaning of Sampradana, recipient. Vijaya. Vijaya is twice born, meaning of contextually, the priest. Twice born means one who has got a second janma with Upanayana Samskara. Devadatta Vijaya Dhanam Dadati. This is Karaka Vibhakti. Another is Acharya Shishyebhya Shastram Upadishati. There is another meaning of Sampradana. That Sampradana has to be used when the teaching is done in a formal setup. In a formal setup, there is a teacher who teaches to his students. Then those students, if it is a formal setup, formal teaching, then that Shishya will be the Sampradana. So Acharya, that recipient, will take fourth case. Acharya Shishyebhya Shastram Upadishati. Upadishati. Upadishati teaches. Who teaches? Acharya. First case. Kartari Prayoga. Acharya Upadishati. What does he teach? Shastram. Shastram, second case, because it is an object of something which is taught. What is taught? Shastram. To whom? That to whom is Sampradana, recipient. Shishyebhya. Plural. Ramebhya. Like Ramebhya, Shishyebhya. Multiple Shishyas. More than two are there. Therefore, plural, Shishyebhyaha, he is teaching, he is giving the jnana to his students. That is the karaka artha of Sampradana. Karaka artha is Sampradana of Chaturthi, fourth case. Non-karaka vibhakti is Yajate. Yajate, you don't see Yakara, but you see Atmane, therefore it is Kartari Prayoga. You look for Karta. Karta is not supplied, so you just say one worships. Yajate, one worships. What does he worship? Whom does he worship, or what does he worship? That will be in second case. Devan. Ramaha Ramu Ramaha Ramam Ramu Raman. Like that, Devaha Devo Deva Ha Devam Devo Devan. Devan plural, the object. Second case, plural, will be Devan. He worships Devas. Devas, deities. So one worships deities. For what purpose? So that is what is called Tadartya Chaturthi. Tadartya means for that purpose. Tad artha is coming together in a samasa. Tad arthe, for the purpose. So tad arthe in the sense of purpose. So that is for the purpose of what? That, for the purpose of that, and that can be replaced by the word, which is punyaya. So punyarthe, the meaning will be tad arthe will be punya. Punya will be the, will replace the pronoun tat in tad arthe. You will say punyarthe. This is the meaning, punyarthe, and therefore it will take punyarthe meaning, the word will take fourth case, punyaya, like ramaya, punyaya, punya is the shabda, punya, akaranta, so punyaya, devan yajate, he, one worships devas, deities, to gain punya, punyaya, to gain, see punyaya, you just get punya, but gain, how do you get? To gain is the purpose. For the purpose of punya, you can say one worships deities for the purpose of punya, to gain punya. This is the purpose of action. Fourth case. Then fourth case, there are various words which govern fourth case. Like we say namaste. Namaste is a sandhi. Namaha is the word, and sakara, visarga has become sakara when it is followed by te. Te is to you. Te tubhyam, to you. That is fourth case. And namaha. Namaha, namaste is namaha te. That namaha governs fourth case, te is fourth case, namastubhyam, namaste, both have the same meaning. Tubhyam and te are optional forms of the fourth case singular of the yushmat shabda, to mean you, second person, you. Namaha, so shivaya namaha, te namaha, tubhya namaha, all these are the shivaya is what? Basically, shivaya, ramaya, latayai, as in say devyai, to devi. So all these are what? This fourth case is because namaha governs fourth case. Salutation to Shiva, salutation to Rama, or reverence to Rama. Swasti, swasti also. So swasti prajabhya, or prajabhya, swasti prajabhya is praja shabda, prajabhya is plural. That is fourth case plural. प्रजाभ्यः नमः प्रजाभ्यः स्वस्ति स्वस्ति अस्तु स्वस्ति प्रजाभ्यः स्वस्ति जनेभ्यः दैट्स व्हाट शी इज यूज्ड ऑल दिस इज स्वस्ति गवर्न्स फोर प्लेस स्वाहा सो मे देयर बी स्वस्ति मीन्स मे देयर बी वेलफेयर फॉर हुम फॉर द पीपल स्वाहा स्वाहा व्हेन यू ऑफर ऑल्सो स्वाहा इंद्राय स्वाहा इंद्राय इदम नमः सो ऑल दिस इज अग्नेय स्वाहा सो अग्नेय इदम नमः That is fourth case because Swaha also governs fourth case. Oblation is to Indra. This is fourth case. Panchami artha. Panchami is apadane panchami is the karaka artha. Apadane is source or origin of any action that we have seen. So for example, patati. Patati means kartari prayoga, falls. Then you ask, falls, who falls or what falls? So that will take first case. And here in neuter, not who falls. So if say you say Devadatta Patati, Devadatta falls. But Phalam, the fruit falls and Phalam is neuter. Phalam. First case also is Phalam, second case is also a Phalam. Phalam Patati. But here it is first case because it is Kartari Pravyoga. The fruit falls. Now fruit falls from what? That from what is the, in the action of falling, Patati, Patanam. Patanam is falling. The pat dhatu here, pat is dhatu. In that falling action, the tree is still. The fruit is falling, but the tree is still, and therefore tree will take panchami as source of that source of from where an unmoving source from which something falls. So origin, it is an origin. Phalam vrikshat, vriksha is the akaranta pullinga shabda, and panchami of that is vrikshat. Like Ramat, you will get vrikshat. Vrikshat phalam patati. The fruit falls from the tree because vriksha is the origin of action. Similarly, there are other apadana also, there are technical definitions like what is the source of fear also. Again, source, but source of fear or that from which you need one needs protection. That will also be called apadana and therefore take panchami. Let's say I have fear from someone that source like Rakshasa is the source of fear. Or Vyagra, here the tiger is the source of fear. So Bibheti, Bibheti Kartari Prayoga, one is afraid. Again you see Bhi is the Dhatu, you remove Ti, you will get Bibhi, Bibhe you will get Bibhe. And Bibhe, you can say that the A is a Guna, Guna letter. And Guna of what? Ikara, Ikara is Raswa or Dirga. So Bibhi or Bibhi is what you will reverse engineer Bibheti as to find the Dhatu. And you Bibhi, you see, there is a, except for that Mahaprana, Bakara and Bhakara, Mahaprana difference is there as in something to hint. And then you see it can be Bibhi also. Bibhi, Bibhi has become Bibhi. Therefore, you see duplication and then you can guess that the Dhatu will be Bhi, the second part. The first part is reduplication, third Gana. And the Dhatu is either Hraswa Bhi or Dirga Bhi. And you will find Bhi as a Dirga Bhi. Bhi is in the sense of fear. Bhi bhaye, in the sense of fear. That is the dhatu. So one fears, one is afraid. So one is afraid. Who is afraid? Devadatta, karta. Devadatta is afraid. Afraid of what? So of what there is not shashti. Afraid of what? Of will sound like, because if you just know of as a translation of sixth case, then Dasharata, Ramaha is son of Dasharata. That son of Dasharata will become Dasharata will take sixth case. Dasharatasya putra, sixth case. But of is not the translation only for sixth case. It can also be for fifth case. But there of, they have to understand what is that. Fear of is fear from also. So that is the source of fear. Therefore it will take fifth case Vyagra. Fear, Devadatta is afraid of the tiger. That of the tiger is because it is Panchami Vyagra, like Ramat. Vyagra, because it is the source of fear. Tiger is the source of fear. Then Ishvara Dukkhat Naran Rakshati. Rakshati, Rakshdhatu. Raksh to protect. Rakshati protects. Who protects? Ishvara. First case, Kartari Prayoga, Karta goes in first case. Ishvara Rakshati. Ishvara protects. Main sentence. Whom does he protect? Naran. People. He protects people. Then he protects people from what? So that whatever you have, so from papa, from dukkha, that papa or dukkha will take panchami. Why? Because it is that from which one needs protection. So that from which one needs protection, that will also Goen Panchami. Basic meaning, if you understand fear, one has fear, then this is a derivative meaning we can understand. Although the sutra itself is different, but something related meaning we can keep in our head, and thereby we land on Panchami. Dukkhat Naran Rakshati. One protects, Ishvara protects people from sorrow, from papa. Then Jalat Kamalam Jayate, the source of birth. Again, source of birth, cause of birth, but it is a source also. That also takes Panchami, takes fifth case. Jayate. Jayate here, see now, here Jayate. Jayate, you can see here sitting there. Right? Here sitting there, therefore what you will know is that Te Atmane Pada. Then you see here, whether Kartari or Karmani, you see here. When you see here, then you can say it is Karmani Prayoga, unless it is Atmane Dhatu in fourth Gana. And here you will find that G is the Dhatu is Jan Dhatu. And Jan, that Nakara Lopa happens, you get Jan Dhatu, you get Ja. Some other context if you have to see, we will see. But Jayate is the form of Jan Dhatu. Is born. So you will say is born. What is born? Kamalam. This Kamalam is born. Now see, if we look at it, if it is Atmane Pada in fourth Gana, then also you will get the same form. So you have to be careful as to what it is. You can say that, but if you say something is born, then it can be Karta. And what is born, if you ask, then also it will mean Karta only. So here, if you say is born, there also you will mean, it is not in the past tense. It is difficult to translate this in any other Prayoga. It will be only translated as is born. Therefore, it is a Kartari Prayoga, not Karmani Prayoga. This year, Kamalam is born. The is not, it is not like, how do I, in fact, this Jan Dhatu, I can't translate it in any other way. Let's say is born, we'll not spend more time on this. Kamalam. Kamalam is born, Lotus is born. So, what is it born from? So, Karta of the sentence is Kamalam. Kamalam is born. The lotus is born. Now, what is it born from? That from, we can also say in water. In water is also possible, but here, Jalat Kamalam Jayate. Jalat is from water, it is, that is the intention. Therefore, it will go, take Panchami as the source of birth. Cause of birth is, actually it is not cause here, Jalat. Jala is not the cause. But then you don't see anywhere else. So if we don't know much of science, then how will you explain? So we say, I have always seen here, so it is always born from water. Thereby it will become a source. At least source in for a person who sees. As though, because you see it popping up in water. So it is, does not mean that really that is where it is born. The seed may definitely be there. But we are saying that from water is in the sense of source, because that is how we see. Perception is like that. Then another, this we have seen that in a formal setup, sampradana, fourth case, is for the shishyas. But here in a formal teaching, the teacher will take panchami in a formal setup. So, upadhyaya vyakranam adhite. Adhite, one study. So, one studies. What does one study? So one, because the karta is not intended, kartari prayoga, but karta is not, vivaksha, it is not there. Therefore, you say one studies, adhite. One studies what? Vyakaranam, grammar. One studies, the vyakarana, akaranta shabda, but it is taking second case because it is, one studies what? The akamsha is, it goes in second case, answer to that. Vyakaranam adhite, grammar, one studies grammar. From whom? Upadhyaya, from the teacher. Why upadhyaya? Because it is in a formal setup that one is learning. Therefore, upadhyaya takes panchami. And you can say, learn. In English also you will ask, from whom do you learn? From whom does he learn? That from is panchami. That is karaka. Non-karaka vibhakti, just like tritiya, you also have panchami. Hetau panchami. Hetau panchami, in the sense of hetu, there can be a panchami also. So, a common example in Nyaya Shastra is Parvato Vanniman. Parvata, the mountain is on fire. Then you ask, why do you say that? What is the reasoning? That reason will go in the fifth case. So, Parvato Vanniman, kasmat karanat, due to what reason? Due to dhumat. I perceive dhuma. I don't see the fire. but I see dhuma, smoke I see. Therefore, dhuma, smoke will take panchami because it is a hetu. Dhuma, since the, because of smoke, the mountain has to have fire. This is the reasoning. And dhuma is a panchami of dhuma shabda in the sense of hetu. Hetu panchami, not apadana, not, I don't know what they call in English, but all this will be confusing if you just stick to English words. Okay, then when there is a comparison, you are comparing two things and separating out one from the other, then that that which is still, again here, an extension of upadana is that source which is still from which you are separating out. But here it is in the sense of comparison. When you find out some quality and then you do a comparative study that one is better than the other, something like that, then that from which you are separating out and comparing with, that will take panchami. So example, vishishyate. Vishishyate, you see, vishishyate, here is sitting here. So shish dhatu, vi purvaka shish dhatu, vi is the upasarga, shish is the dhatu, and ya is the karmaniya, karmaniyak, and te is the atmane te. So vishishyate means what? Vishishyate is greater. Translation is greater. What is greater? Karma should go. So satyam. Satyam is greater or better. Satyam stands out rather. It stands out. That is how we will say, Kartari Prayoga will say it stands out. But in it is greater. Something is greater than what? Now again, shishya, here it could be vishishyate is greater. Here it is not Karmani Prayoga. Again, Kartari Prayoga only, because shish will also possibly be in fourth gana. Because you see, is greater is the meaning. Something is better. So is better, like jayate also, again, is something is born, something is better. That is Kartari Prayoga only. This is satyam is better. Satyam is better than what? Than what? The than what will be a comparison, and what is compared is maunat satyam vishishyate. If you are in a situation in which you can keep mum or you can talk the truth. So speaking the truth is always better than keeping silence. Now, of course, this is a statement of dharma. Then apatakala there may be some other dharma, but in this concept, maunat satyam vishishyate. Why panchami maunat? Mauna shabda panchami is maunat, because compared to mauna, truth is better. This is how the compared to silence, truth is better. Or she is translated as speaking truth is better than silence. So you can translate it in many ways. Then there are a lot of words which govern panchami, like purva, para, uttara and pra, which are also directional comparisons in direction or in time. In all those will take. There are a lot of these. Panchami is quite vast that way. I'll just mention purva. So jnana, purva, sausara. Before jnana, purva is before. Before what? That before that is directional. So directional will also be jnana, purva. Directional in the sense of in time also. In time, direction in time or direction in space. Well, direction in time does not make sense, but it is something which is beyond this. You see, beyond can be beyond in space also and time also. So jnana, purva, sausara. Jnana, paraha, moksha. Before jnana, there is samsara. After jnana, there is liberation. Etasmat bhagat uttara bhaga asti. So uttara is something other than this. Later part is there. Later from what? Bhagat. From this part. Compared to this part, there is something else. So when you, from the reference point of this point, there is something else. That from the reference of this is the panchami. Prak also is like before. Before what? Before jnana. Jnanat purvaha or jnanat prak will mean same thing. Anantaram also. Anantaram is After what? Snanat anantaram mandiram gachyati. One goes to temple, mandiram gachyati. One. So gachyati, kartari prayoga, mandiram is the destination. Second case, because it's an object of the destination of going to. Anantaram, after snana, after bath, snanat panchami. I'll skip the others. Itara, bhinna, rute. You can go through this. There are a lot of words which govern. Fifth case. Shashti Vibhakti is Sambandha. Sambandha Shashti. Devadattasya Griham. So here it is. Not house of Devadatta. But if you translate, what is Sambandha Shashti? Devadatta's house. So Devadatta's house. This Devadatta's house will be Sambandha Shashti. Otherwise it's difficult to understand what kind of Shashti this is. Karmani Shashti will also be like that. Karma also goes in sixth case in some kind of prayoga when Kridanta padas are used and the dhatu of the Kridanta Pratipadika, that some dhatus, karta or karma, can go in sixth case. And Shesha Shashti is also there. Shesha Shashti means and there is no vivaksha, then anything which is not intended to be conveyed as specific with a specific focus, that goes in sixth case. Here, generally, you start with Sambandha Shashti. And I said that there is no karaka in sixth case. It is never connected with a dhatu. It is always a connection between two nouns. That is shashti. Saptami. Saptami is adhikarana, karaka vibhakti, which means the locus of action. You have seen this. Devadatta mahanase pachati. Pachati, Devadatta cooks where? In the kitchen. So in the kitchen is the locus of action. Then saptami, non-karaka is also what is called a sati saptami, when something happens. So there are two actions. When this happens, that happens. That will take saptami. So putre sati devadatta grihe tishtati. Putre sati, sati is like giving away the meaning of putre, seventh case. When the son is there, devadatta grihe tishtati. Griha, devadatta remains in the house, tishtati remains in the house, grihe, in the house. Here in the house is locus. Locus of the action, it is karaka vibhakti, but putre, not in the sun, it is when the sun is there, then devadatta remains in the house. This grihe is a different saptami than putre. And then putre pushte sati devadatta tushta bhavati, when the sun is happy, then or nourished, when the sun is pushte, when he is nourished, then devadatta is happy. That is sati saptami. Vishesha saptami, all these are there. Vishesha saptami already mentioned, which is the dhatu pata meaning, when you say that bhu sattayam, sattayam means in the sense of, that is vishesha saptami, in the sense of satta, being, existence, which is the meaning of the dhatu bhu. I have taken a couple of minutes. I'll not summarize this, go through this summary, and since I'll be traveling, I may not have internet connection to do the presentation. So this is the reason I wanted to do the the meanings of the noun today, so we can understand some basic sentences. We know what kartari karmani prayoga is, we know what kind of cases are possible, but of course it will take time to settle down. I also wanted to do at least one feminine word declension. If possible, try to go through the dhatu part, Subanta book that I have shared on the wall. Go through some words as to what are the declensions for various kinds of endings, like Rama Shabda, Marut Shabda, then neuter one, say Phala Shabda, and Rama Shabda. At least these, if you go through, then since the vibhaktis are understood, it should not be difficult to, when I say this vibhakti, but the forms may be difficult when we do Tattva Bodha. I would like to start Tattva Bodha in the next class, if I can do it on Wednesday. Because I'll not have good internet for to do board work and share a book. Either you can go through the book and I can do an audio, or I can do a Tattva Bodha audio class. We'll see how that goes. And then we'll come back and finish Sanskrit also. We'll do this. We'll do the more of Sanskrit, but a little later if I don't have enough bandwidth. Okay, we'll stop here. Sorry for taking a little more time. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.